Hi class, this is Professor Smith with part two of graphing a line through a given point with a given slope. In this example, we have the following. Graph the line with slope -3 through the point -5, -2. Our first step is to graph the ordered pair, so I'll use our pen tool. I'm going to start at the origin. I'm going to move to the left, -5, and then go down 2. And that will give me the ordered pair, -5, -2. Step 2 is to express the slope as a ratio. In our example, the slope is 3, pardon me, is -3. And that is not written as a ratio. Anytime we have a whole number, we can rewrite it as divided by 1. So our ratio is -3/1. We're going to also recognize that -3/1 could also be written as 3/-1. So there's more than one representation, but we're going to use this first one. Third step is to determine the rise. Our rise is the numerator, which is -3, and our run is the denominator, which is 1. I'm going to go to our ordered pair using the pen tool. I'm going to rise -3, which means to go down 3, 1, 2, 3. Don't place a point there. That's just giving you directions to move up or down. That's your rise. The rise is up and down like an elevator. And also, rise rhymes with y. The y-axis, so you know that's going to be your y-direction movement. So it's -3, so we're going down 3. Then the run is 1. Since it's a positive 1, we're going to move to the right 1. So that gives us our second point. We can use our plot point tool. Our plot line tool. Select the first point, select the second point, and that gives us the graph of the line that goes through -5, -2 with the slope of -3. While I'm here, I should point out too that when you have a slope that is negative, you're always moving down on the roller coaster. So I'm going down on the roller coaster. If any of you ski, I'm going down on the slopes. Whenever you have positive slope, that means I'm moving up on the roller coaster. I'm going uphill. So positive slope will rise to the right, and a negative slope will fall to the right. I'll click the undo button to get rid of that second graph. So we'll select check. Way at the bottom of the screen. I'm not sure why it's so far down. And again, we've gotten it correct. So I hope this part two of graphing the line given the slope and an ordered pair has been helpful for you. That's Professor Smith signing off at 916-813-9027. Bye-bye.